Minasan Konnichiwa, this is Braveheart. Now, today I'm here to talk to you about something serious that happened on YouTube a couple of days ago. I'm going to be extremely busy for a while, so I figured I'd get these next two videos out as soon as possible. One of my favorite reviewers, going by the name of the Mysterious Mr. Enter, was terminated from YouTube. For those of you who do not know who the Mysterious Mr. Enter is, he's basically a cartoon reviewer. He has reviewed several cartoons, even some of the worst episodes of SpongeBob, such as Atlantis Squarepanis, and even some of the parts of the Alan Gregory show. Now, the Mysterious Mr. Enter was taken down because Viacom made copyright claims against his channel. I got word of this when my friend on YouTube, Splash the Otter, mentioned it over Skype. Many of you who have been on YouTube for years probably know what Viacom is by now, but for those of you who don't know what it is, Viacom is the company that owns Nickelodeon and other studios that make cartoons. In the past, Viacom has sued YouTube for having some of their content on their site, which I believe was kind of a stupid move. It wasn't really YouTube's fault during that time. It was really the person who uploaded it that was responsible. But, in any case, getting back to the point. After this lawsuit was made and when YouTube came under attack by the music industry, YouTube devised the Content ID system as a result. Now, if you're new to YouTube, the Content ID system is a system that scans every video that you upload for any copyrighted content that other companies don't want on the site. If it finds anything that is copyrighted, the video is either claimed by the companies who own it so that you can't make any ad revenue off of it, or the video is taken down and it leaves you with a strike on your account. If you get 3 strikes, your channel is automatically shut down and all of your videos are deleted. If that happens, you cannot create another channel unless you use a different email address. Now, the Content ID system is a good thing in some retrospects, because it stops people from using YouTube as a hosting site for pirated media. The sad part, however, is that this system can be easily abused, because the Content ID system, given that it's operated by a machine, does not know what fair use is. Mr. Enter's videos were an example of fair use, because he was only doing his job by critiquing cartoon episodes. He kept the video audio silent for the majority of the time as he commentated over it about what was wrong and what was right about the episode. Critique exists for the purpose of helping the entertainment and video game industry learn from their mistakes, and it also helps us avoid media that we do not want to see or play. Now, I can make a whole video on how to deal with this Content ID system, but I'm not going to. There are already plenty of other people on YouTube who've done that. Here are a few examples on how the Content ID system is easily abused. I'm not joking about this. Any company in the world has the ability to destroy everything that you created on the internet with just the push of a button. Back in 2013, Total Biscuit posted a video of Day One Gary's incident on YouTube. As a result, the developer of the game, Wild Game Studio, removed the video for criticizing the game for how bad it was. Total Biscuit eventually was able to fight back against this with some help from his network and was able to get his video back up. But another example of something like this happening is the Shining Force 3 incident. Years ago, Sega removed many videos of Shining Force 3 from YouTube. They even went as far as to remove videos that were only talking about the game, no gameplay footage whatsoever. As a result, about 17 channels received strikes. Most channels that did were never able to fight back against it. Some channels were even terminated and have not even since come back. And the reason why Sega did this was just so they can garner more attention to their trailer of Shining Arc. Eventually, Sega stopped doing this after many gamers went against them. However, Sega has not since apologized for it. In fact, back in the December of 2013, YouTube made a Content ID sweep over every single one of their videos. Many videos, including gaming videos such as game review shows and even Let's Plays, were either claimed or taken down. Thankfully, though, some companies stood up and helped many gamers on YouTube during this time. Some companies, however, didn't care, such as Nintendo, for example. Viacom, however, is another shining example of how the Content ID system is abused. This is basically how broken the Content ID system is. Ever since what happened in 2013, YouTube hasn't fixed this. Because of this, I wasn't even able to start my channel until months after the incident. In fact, every time I post a video, I always have to pray for the best and hope that my video doesn't get taken down. Thankfully, though, I haven't had this happen yet, but a few of my Tales of Vesperia videos have been claimed by the Warner Music Group, or WMG for short. All I can say is that they have been known for claiming many music videos in the past. I can understand why they claimed my first episode of Vesperia, given that I showed the entire game opening. But as for the other videos, they claimed them because they contained music that was playing in the background, which I will remind you was actually playing in the game itself. Thankfully, I didn't get any strikes on my account, and I don't intend to make any money off these videos. I'm only doing this for entertainment and to show people on how to play certain games. But even so, the fact that the Content ID system is so messed up still freaks me out to this day. Anyone's videos or their channel can be deleted if a company feels like it. All that someone from a company needs to do is just press a button and it's done. However, there is a light of hope. If you feel like that your video was rightfully up on the internet, and yet a company keeps screwing you over in the worst ways possible, you can turn to the Electronic Frontier Foundation. This is a charity that usually tries to do what it can to protect your rights on the internet. It may be the best option if worse comes to worse. There are other ways to combat the Content ID system, but again, there are other people on YouTube who can explain it a bit better than I can. But in any case, given what has happened so far, I do know that the Content ID system needs to change eventually. Maybe companies should go through some kind of procedure before they can take down anything they want from YouTube. Like, for example, once they make a claim, someone at YouTube, a real human being, rather than a robot, looks over the video and decides whether if it's fair use or not. That would be a much better system. But here's the real answer of why they don't have this kind of system. And I quote this from Mr. Enter himself. YouTube does not like work. It isn't guaranteed to happen, but maybe if we raise our opinions to YouTube, we might be able to show them how this is all wrong. If this gets worse, maybe people might choose to abandon YouTube and move on. There are plenty of other video sharing sites out there. Some people even have their own websites. I don't have a website yet because I'm not very skilled with coding. But if you are going to stay on YouTube, I would advise you to be extremely careful of what you post until YouTube does something about this problem. Remember, three strikes and your channel, along with all of its content, are gone. In case if that were to happen, I would also advise you to keep backup files of your videos. If you tend to make a lot of videos, those are likely to take up quite a lot of data. So I would recommend getting an external hard drive. But be sure to also make a backup channel somewhere as well. Maybe even a website if you know how to make one. That's about all I have to say for today. But yes, the system is easily abused by companies, and that needs to be fixed. If you have the time to do so, I would recommend that you support Mr. Enter in any way that you can in his time of need. I have links to his Dailymotion, DeviantArt, and Twitter accounts in the description. Hopefully we might be able to help him in some way to help him regain his channel. Thank you all for watching. My next video will cover my thoughts on the PS4 along with its new cloud gaming service, PlayStation Now. So, until next time, this is Braveheart, Godspeed, and sayonara, everyone. I will see you guys later.